Hey everyone, Tracy at Mystically Divine Tarot. How's everyone today? I hope you're all doing great. Welcome to my channel and welcome to today's Pick a Card reading. Today we are going to be asking Spirit their thoughts of you, okay? So your person on your mind, what are they thinking of you at this time? Okay, whatever comes through, we shall see, okay? Please remember to like the video and also to subscribe if you haven't already. I greatly appreciate it. Appreciate you all being here as well. Anyone interested in a private reading, there will be a link in the description box below and also at the end of each section of the video, okay? So today we have three tarot decks to choose from, with crystal number one being the citrine crystal. Oops, almost dropped it. Citrine crystal with the Royal Romance Tarot. For crystal number two, we have the green fluorite crystal. With the Light Seers Tarot. And for crystal number three, we have the red aventurine crystal with the Muse Tarot. Okay, so choose which crystal or card deck resonates with you most, and I will see you in your reading. If you resonated with crystal number one, the citrine crystal, and the Royal Romance Tarot, this will be your reading, okay? Today we are asking Spirit their thoughts of you, okay? So your person on your mind, what are their thoughts of you at this time? For crystal number one, please. This person's thoughts of crystal number one. Ooh, they highly respect you. They think you do the right thing by yourself. Very nice energy coming through. They respect you very, very much, this person, okay? Let's see with the tarot. Wow, there's a deep level of respect here and love here. Let's see. Strength and... Ah, nice. So you have some strong boundaries, okay? You really, you know, you put boundaries down that you feel at the time is necessary with strength. You're very strong. They feel you're very strong. They think you're incredibly powerful too, is what I'm picking up there. Almost like an intuitive feeling coming through the strength card. But anyway, okay, so intuitive, strong. You have boundaries. You feel that are right for you at this time. Let's see. What are their thoughts of crystal number one, please? What are their thoughts of crystal number one? This person's thoughts, please. Ooh, Ace of Cups. They're deeply in love with you. This person has fallen deeply head over heels in love with you. They want a new start. So some sort of shift happening, new start. So someone could be, you know, asking you out, wanting to be your significant other here. Nice, very nice. Okay, let's see what else for crystal number one, please. Their thoughts of crystal number one. Their person's thoughts of crystal number one, please. Wow, Nine of Cups. You make this person's wishes come true too. You're like their dream person is what I'm picking up here. You tick off all the boxes. You really light this person up on the inside. You give them faith and hope. What else? Let's get some more. Queen of Swords. What is this Queen of Swords about? Queen of Swords for crystal number one. This person's thoughts of crystal number one, please. Why the Queen of Swords? Knight of Swords flipped over here. So yeah, so I feel here that you're wanting to take something slow is what I'm picking up. You're wanting to take something slow. So that could be the boundary you set here. Let's see, strength. I'm picking up sort of an intuitive feeling coming through here as well. You're very powerful, intuitive. Ooh, Six of Cups. Could be a past life connection we're talking about here. Yeah, you have an intuitive knowing about it. Yeah, that's why that intuition was coming through there. Okay. So past life soulmate or twin flame we're talking about here. This person sees that you know something, okay, is what I'm picking up there. Ace of Cups? Why the Ace of Cups for crystal number one? Ooh, Eight of Pentacles. Ooh. So they think that you've put a lot of hard work into yourself is what I'm getting here. They really feel that you are like mastering yourself is what I'm getting. I got mastering your skills at the bottom here. So you're really, there's something about, it could be your work, your career, your life in general. You're just, they really, really love this about you too. Absolutely. It's making them, I feel, even want you more is what I'm feeling there. Ooh. Look at this. Look at this. Nine of Cups, Ten of Pentacles. Oh my goodness. Crystal number one. This is huge. Okay. You make this person's wishes come true. And I feel like this person really wants long-term stability. This is the happily ever after card. Ten of Pentacles. Okay. This is an abundance of love, material things, the whole kit and caboodle. Okay. Even better than the Ten of Cups because it includes the love, right? So, yeah, this is big. This person, you really, this, you're like they're the person that they've dreamt to marry their entire life is what I'm feeling here. Big, big energy. Okay, let's see with the oracle cards for crystal number one, please. Crystal number one, expression. Ooh, so they're thinking about expressing something to you. Could be this love offer here, okay, is what I'm picking up. Yeah, they want to say something. Could be their feelings as well, okay? They could be thinking about expressing their feelings. Maybe offering love, letting you know how much you mean to them. Wow, there's a lot coming through. So a lot of different situations. Obviously, everything won't resonate for everyone. Their thoughts of crystal number one, please. There was a lot coming through there. So maybe some of you have someone who hasn't expressed feelings at all. And maybe that's why that came through there for some of you. Ooh, beautiful. Very nice card here. Give thanks for the blessings of love soon to come your way. Know that you deserve to be and have all that your heart truly desires. This person knows that you love them, okay, is what I'm picking up here. And maybe you didn't feel like you were worthy of them or something at some point, okay? And that might just be for some of you, but give thanks for that blessing soon to come your way, right? Because there's a love offer here that this person is thinking about. So just kind of be grateful and thankful within your heart, right? Show gratitude for that love that you feel from this person is what I'm getting there. Okay, let's get more for crystal number one, please. Crystal number one's person's thoughts of them. Ooh, take inspired action. So yeah, they're thinking about taking some sort of action toward you. You could have inspired this action because it's take inspired action, okay? So something you might have said or done might have inspired them to, maybe it's this hard work, I don't know. Something about this work here, possibly. Maybe you've given them inspiration and hope for the future. I don't know exactly, but work is definitely coming through there. So it has something to do with that. But you've inspired this person in some way. For some of you, it might be about work. You know, maybe what you're doing for work or something, you're really an inspiration to others or something like that. For others, maybe it's not about work, but you've inspired this person in some way. Okay, let's see what else. For crystal number one, please. Crystal number one. What is their person's thoughts of them, please? They really respect you, this person. They have a deep level of respect coming through with that noble one, and they feel like you always do the right thing. Ooh. Okay, so this stillness card, what I'm getting here is that they think that you have done a lot of meditation, a lot of inner work. They can kind of see something in you. This swan, too, could be representative of twin flames as well. But they see something deeper, okay, deeper in you. Beautiful energy. It's very calming. I don't, you know, it's like they feel like you're calm, maybe, in their presence, or they just see you as a calm person. Something like that coming through here. Let's see what else for crystal number one, please. What is this person's thoughts of crystal number one? Very nice energy, though. This person, they love you very much. They respect your boundaries. I feel like maybe you wanted them to go a little slower or something with this card here. Yeah, see, there's that meditation. I told you, I was feeling it already with that stillness card. They feel like you really kind of, you're stable in yourself, okay? Like you're really calm, cool, collected. You're really stable in yourself. So again, they think very highly of you. They have this high level of respect, and I think that has something to do with it as well. Maybe they were, you know, in the past, maybe they've dealt with people that, you know, really couldn't keep their energy like stable, you know, like maybe you know, like people that fly in off the handle all the time, things like that, like some sort of chaos possibly in their past or something like that. Their thoughts of you. Ooh, inner knowing. Wow, so they know twin flame. Yeah, they, so for some of you, this person knows you're their twin flame is what I'm getting here. Okay, they have a deep inner knowing. It's not just a thought anymore, I heard. It's not just a thought anymore, I know. Okay, so, wow, that's pretty big. So, there could have been, if you're the divine feminine here, the divine masculine might have been in a state of denial at some point, or could have just been thinking it was all in his head, honestly, with what came through there, okay? It's not just a thought anymore, I know. Yeah, there's something, there was some sort of a denial period or something like that. But they know now, they really do. It's in their thoughts too, okay? So their thoughts are matching up with their inner being, so that's good. Let's see their thoughts of crystal number one. And of course, not everyone has, you know, it might not be your twin flame, so maybe that doesn't apply to you. Or if you don't, if it's not your twin flame, this could simply mean that this person just knows that you're right for them, okay? They have an inner knowing that you're the right person for them, okay? Let's see what else for crystal number one, their person's thoughts of crystal number one at this time. Whoa. Yes, here it is, that intuitive, right? I told you. I felt it through strength way earlier in the reading, but here it is. They know that you know something. Okay, so maybe they know and they're wondering if you know. You know what I mean? Like they're like, "I know." And I think this person knows too. Crystal number one knows too, cuz there was something about your intuition coming through here. So I do feel like maybe they're questioning if you know the truth within you, you know? I don't think they're questioning it, though. They think that you do know was what I was getting here. So, yeah. Anyway, all right, let's get another card out. Look at this. The two messages I got here came out back to back. How synchronistic is that? Okay, Angel of Strength. Yeah, they see, ooh, card number 50 as well. And a beautiful lion. Courage, strength, fire energy coming through as well. The number 8. Okay, so that might be relevant to someone. Angel of Strength, though, they do see you as extremely powerful, strong, okay, in yourself, right? This person They know that you are a pretty divine being, okay? Like, you, I feel there's this inner strength about you, okay? It's a deep, like, inner strength. You've maybe gone through a lot in your life, and you've really risen above. Let's see what else for crystal number one. What is this person's thoughts of crystal number one, please? So what I'm getting here is they're really wanting closeness with you. They're thinking about closeness is what came through. So time to rest a while, maybe kind of wanting to get away. There's mountains here in the background as well. Oh, look at this little thing here, this little stick with the little thing on the end. It almost reminds me of fool energy, okay? So this could also indicate like a new start type of thing, getting away, resting, recuperating, really kind of enjoying closeness is what I was feeling there. But that thing reminds me of the Fool card. So I'm picking up like a new beginning there. Like, you know, taking that leap of faith. Interesting. Very nice energy. Okay, crystal number one. What is this person's thoughts of crystal number one, please? Focused. Yeah, see, I told you, you are super focused. They really see that you are just dedicated is what I'm getting. Dedicated, focused, driven. Okay, very independent. Yeah. Wow. This again, they really respect you. Vacation. And I kept shuffling, and I don't even know if I was planning to get more than one, but vacation flew out. That's exactly what I was kind of feeling here, like a getaway of some sort. Now I'm going to get more, though, because that was weird. But yeah, so they're probably planning or wanting to, you know, thinking about it, you know. This is their thoughts, so they could be thinking about, like, going on a vacation with you, just getting away. Happiness. Wow. Yeah, you make them very happy. Like I said, you check off all the boxes here. This is like the dream person that they've always wanted to marry is what I'm feeling. Twin flames coming out. For you twin flames out there, there was definitely some twin flame energy coming through. This is just further confirmation. For you twin flames out there that this could be your twin flame, you know, that you're dealing with here, right? So all right, crystal number one, this is what I have for you for today. I really hope this reading was helpful. As always, please give it a like and remember to subscribe if you haven't already. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you in the next reading. If you resonated with crystal number two, the green fluorite crystal, and the light seer's tarot, this will be your reading, okay? Today we are asking spirit their thoughts of you. Okay, so let's see for crystal number two, what is their person's thoughts of them at this time? Ooh, wow, threshold, that's pretty big. So they're thinking about doing something soon is what I'm getting here. There's a huge transformation that's happened and they're thinking about doing something soon. Interesting. Okay, crystal number two. What is the person's thoughts of them? Thinking about doing something soon. Maybe we'll figure out what that is with the tarot. Two of Pentacles. So bringing some sort of balance. They're thinking, or you're balanced. You're balanced. They're thinking you're balanced. So they're thinking you have a balanced approach to life. You are stable in yourself. Let's see. Okay, what else? Crystal number two, their person's thoughts of them. We'll get more with the clarifiers there. Balanced approach to life. So you kind of, you go through life taking it as it comes, so to speak, you know? Let's see. What else? For crystal number two, what is this person's thoughts of crystal number two? Ooh. Four of Wands. So they're thinking about stability with you. They want long term. And of course, these are general readings. So remember, not all messages will resonate for everyone, okay? But someone here wanting stability, long term, possibly marriage with it being the Four of Wands as well. Wanting to celebrate the love. Ooh, celebrate the love. Yeah, wedding, maybe. Maybe somebody wants to marry you. Six of Pentacles. So they're wanting to be reciprocated in this relationship. They're wanting to give you as much as you give to them. You're balanced. Maybe they're trying to be balanced as well. Maybe they were working on kind of their own life, trying to balance out things in their own life. Because they think that you give a lot. They want to give back. Let's see. What else? Four of Cups. Yeah, they might think they would disappointed you in the past. Yeah, so this person feels like they maybe disappointed you with something in the past. We'll find out more with the clarifier. Nothing much coming through there. Just they think they disappointed you in the past. So maybe they weren't reciprocal. This could have been a situation where they weren't reciprocating energy with you. And they feel like they disappointed you. Okay, Two of Pentacles. So crystal number two, please. What is this Two of Pentacles? For crystal number two, what is this Two of Pentacles? That person's thoughts of them, please. Woo! I almost fell on the floor. Strength card. Ooh. I'm noticing infinity symbols. There's the number eight, and then there's an infinity symbol here. Really stood out to me. So they feel you're very strong, balanced. This is good. They think you're, you know, you're like a catch here, okay? You're strong, you're stable, you're balanced in your own life. So this is good. Four of Wands. This person thinks highly of you. Something there transforming, though, and thinking of doing something real soon with that threshold card. Could be asking you to marry them. That's coming through for someone. Maybe you're in a relationship or something like that, and your person wants to take it to the next level, okay? Threshold could be like really thinking about it, maybe even planning it, okay? Four of Wands, what is this about? Keeping their eye on you. Seeing the details? Something about details? Okay, so maybe if this has to do with Four of Wands, yeah, they could be planning details. Yeah, someone could be planning. This person could be thinking about planning some sort of proposal or something for the long term, okay? Because it was stability too. Something about details coming through here, and they're keeping their eye on you. So maybe they're trying to see how to integrate it into your life or something. Whatever this plan is that they're thinking of. Let's see. Six. It's something to do with stability, marriage, could be a proposal. Six of Pentacles. What is the Six of Pentacles for crystal number two? Big energy here, guys. Two of Cups. Wow. Beautiful, deep, passionate love here. Deep passionate love. Okay, well, I guess it is, because that came through. This isn't necessarily about that, but it definitely came through. So deep passionate love between two people who love each other very deeply. This is about union, okay? Coming together, reciprocated energy. So this is a balanced relationship. This person's looking for something stable, balanced, reciprocal for the long term. They're thinking about this with you, so I feel like for some of you this is about like a next step in a relationship, okay? Four of Cups. I want to know what this is about. They feel like they've disappointed you in the past. What is this about, please? Four of Cups. That's all that really came through there. They feel like they disappointed you in the past. Let's see, please. Hot and cold. They weren't reciprocating. They weren't communicating. This person may have even ghosted you at some point, okay? They feel like they were a disappointment because they really had a lot of feelings. This is deep love, okay? This is powerful, like soulmate twin flame type energy, okay? Very deep, powerful love for you. But they may have ghosted you. They may have seriously gone no contact. Look at the bottom of the deck. Oh my goodness, the Fool energy is down there. Okay, we're taking it. You know how I read, right? Intuitively, I see it. If it means something, it's coming out. New start. Yeah, so for some of you, this could be someone returning to you, okay? Is what I'm picking up with the Fool. Someone returning to your life, wanting a new start, taking that leap of faith, okay? After maybe a period of hot and cold, no contact, something like that, that they really feel they disappointed you in the past, okay? So this person looks like they're planning something to happen soon with threshold for the future that's something stable, okay? Stability, commitment, marriage, something like that, okay? Wanting to reciprocate, wanting to communicate now because they feel like they disappointed you in the past and they really want to communicate with you. This is about incoming back and forth communication too. So really engaging in conversation with you is what I'm getting there, okay? Let's get some oracle messages out here. That was very quick for crystal number two. Thank you. Ooh, warrior. Yeah, that's kind of the energy I was getting here. You're very strong, stable in yourself. You're a fighter. You know, they think you're very powerful. You have your life together, okay, is what I'm feeling. You're very balanced, strong, independent, you know. You got your stuff together. Crystal number two. Let's see what else. The person's thoughts of them, please, for crystal number two. Crystal number two. There we go. Thank you. Ooh. Aw, very nice. Beautiful message here for you, crystal number two. I meant a message for you. I'm thinking of you this very moment. Your love fills me with light. I love you. So this person, thinking about how much they love you. So yeah, this is deep, powerful love coming through. Yeah, this definitely runs deep. Beautiful message there. Let's see what else for crystal number two. Their person's thoughts of them, please. Woo. There's your light again. Your light is shining brightly, okay? Look at this shine. I'm getting like sun energy almost from it as well. Like really happiness, joy. You really do make this person happy on the inside, okay? You light them up. They want something stable with you. Because you kind of, you know, you make them extremely happy is what I'm feeling here with the shine card. So thinking about how happy you make them. Very nice. Let's see. Crystal number two, please. Their person's thoughts of them at this time. Crystal number two. Their thoughts of crystal number two at this time. Crystal number two's person's thoughts, please. Wonders. Wow. This is magical, is what I heard. This is magical. So you are magical. Look at this. This is a beautiful, like, amethyst there. An amethyst point, it looks like, in this card, okay? They're feeling like you're very magical. You shine very brightly. You're just beautiful inside and out is what I'm really picking up here. They really see the depth in you, the strength, you know? Really, really nice energy. Let's see what else for crystal number two. Their person's thoughts of them. A deep breath. Ooh. So what I'm picking up here is this person really kind of needs to meditate to kind of calm themselves when they think of you. I feel like they They get nervous is what I'm getting with this card. They get a little bit like nervous. They have to like really kind of bring it back to center. Because maybe they're afraid to talk to you at this point. It could be that they're fearing that you're upset still. Maybe that's what that's about there. Because they're thinking like there's some sort of nerves coming through with the deep breath. Like I need to meditate before doing this. So it's kind of like calming themselves down. Because the nerves, but it could be about talking. It could be about communication, because they might think you're mad at them or still disappointed in them or something like that. Let's see. Crystal number two's person's thoughts of them at this time, please. Contemplation, exactly. See? Meditation and contemplation. Nice. So they could be in a little bit of a hermit mode doing this right now, doing whatever this plan is, and they're on the threshold of change, transformation. They definitely could be meditating and contemplating a next move, okay? Maybe it's an approach. Like I said, I'm picking up a little bit of nerves there. So what I'm feeling is that they're a little bit nervous about coming forward is what I'm really picking up. So it's probably like what to say, how to approach you, type of energy there. Okay, let's see their thoughts of crystal number two. This person's thoughts of crystal number two, please. They see you as very strong and stable in yourself, so they might be like, you know, crystal number two is gonna like be like, where the heck were you? You know what I mean? Like, you might be strong-willed as well, you know, really kind of you speak your truth, okay? So maybe they're a little bit of afraid. Clean it up, yeah. Yeah, they're trying to work on something within, okay, is what I'm getting here. This is what this is about. They're trying to work on something within. It's something about nervousness. There's some sort of fear. Could be rejection, you know? Could be a fear of rejection or something like that. They're trying to clean up those thoughts, okay, is what I'm picking up, cleaning up thoughts. So that could be why they're in need of doing this here. They're trying to plan an approach and maybe they're overthinking it, okay? That could be what's going on, so clean it up. So this person thinks like their thoughts of you are, they're doing too much of it, in other words, you know? So they're trying to calm the mind. Okay, with clean it up. Okay, let's get... Woo! Wow. Okay, so we got two. So they see you as very valuable. You are, you know, you're a keeper. Door to value. You're a keeper. So they see you as, you know, definitely someone that they could see living their life with, okay? A beautiful, self-sufficient human being, right? With financial constraints coming out, I'm wondering if this could be one of their fears too. Maybe they see you so strong, independent, doing your own thing. Maybe they feel like they're not enough or something like that is coming through. They're not enough, not worthy. Like you kind of, you take care of yourself. You don't need anyone. Because maybe they feel like they need to give you like material things, even though that might not be the case at all. This could be something in this person's thoughts, like I don't have enough to give to crystal number two or something like that. And again, you know, material things aren't what's important, right, at the soul level when we're talking about love. But some people do think that that is something that people are looking for, you know. So it could be that. But if you're self-sufficient, I don't really know why they would be having that fear. Or maybe their thoughts, maybe they're having a little bit of financial difficulty. And that's why it's coming in their thoughts. But it's thoughts about you. So I was thinking, like, do they think they have to give you things? Or, so they're missing you at night. wanting to communicate. Maybe that's when you used to communicate at night. Wanting to communicate, missing you at night is what's coming through here. So at night, you're really heavily on this person's mind. You're in their thoughts a lot. They want to communicate. So I feel for some of you, that might have been when you were communicating a lot with this person, when you were before, like if you were ghosted. Ooh, divine intervention. Wow. So something is shifting and changing here with this divine intervention. Something, maybe that's what's making this shift a possibility sooner. Oh, could this be about this? Yeah, okay. So for some of you, as I looked at this card, Spirit directed me back here. The financial constraints could be related to this plan. They want to give something grand. And they're worried about that. It's in their thoughts. Like they're like, you know, because they feel like you deserve a lot or something like that. Could have something to do with that plan. Spying. Yep. They're looking at details about this situation, whatever this is. Maybe seeing your desires, or you know what you like, things like that. Get a couple more here for crystal number two. Ooh, overthinking. Ooh, divorce. Ah. Okay. Maybe. Ooh, and Divine Feminine flew on my computer too. I didn't see that there. So for some of you, we could be talking about a twin flame. We have Divine Intervention, which I mean, Divine Intervention, you don't have to be a twin flame, but Divine Feminine, you could be the Divine Feminine in a twin flame connection. Only you'll know that, of course. What I was picking up earlier about overthinking. So I think that's what's going on here with your person there. They want to come forward. They want to say something, but they're overthinking it. And divorce. For some of you, this is coming through. Maybe your person ghosted you because they were married, okay? So maybe they needed to, okay, at that point in time, you know? And now they're feeling like a little nervous of coming back. Maybe they got in a divorce and now they want to come forward, but they're a little bit shaky about it, okay? All right, crystal number two. That is what I have for you for today. I really hope this reading was helpful. As always, please give it a like and remember to subscribe if you haven't already. Have a wonderful day and I will see you in the next reading. If you resonated with crystal number three, the red aventurine crystal, and the Muse Tarot, this will be your reading, okay? Today we are asking Spirit, your person's thoughts of you, okay? So whoever you have on your mind, crystal number three, what is this person's thoughts of you? Ooh. What I'm getting here is past lives, which is weird. Memories of the forgotten self. I feel like this is someone from your past. Looking back, thinking about the past that they shared with you. Yeah, looking back at like memories, things like that. Someone from your past, thinking about memories you shared. Okay, crystal number three, please. Ace of Voices. Ooh, they've gained some sort of clarity. So their thoughts are clear about you. We'll find out what that means. Communication? Clear about communication? Some sort of communication you've had, maybe gave them some sort of clarity. Okay, let's get more for crystal number three, please. Their person's thoughts of them. So something that was said, possibly, and of course these are general readings, so it might not resonate for everyone, but something that was said between you, ooh, gave this person some sort of clear thoughts about you, okay? It kind of cleared something up in their mind. The world, wow. So there's a couple coming through. For some of you, this you do mean like the world to this person. You mean the world to me. And for some of you, this what came through was this is the end of that cycle, whatever that means for you. Okay, this is the end of that cycle. So it could be a cycle in their own life. It could be a cycle in this relationship. So maybe if you're in a relationship with this person, maybe there was some sort of a cycle going on, you know, maybe some arguments and things like that, conflict, and now they're resolved and woo, and now they're feeling like the end of the cycle. So they could be thinking about, if you're for some of you, I'm feeling like you're in a relationship with this person because it's coming through. They're thinking about like trouble in the relationship possibly from the past, and they're hoping to, their thoughts here are about clearing that up, finishing that cycle, you know, not going there again, leaving it in the past, okay? They're clear. Maybe something you said to them kind of awoke them to something within themselves, okay? Queen of Inspiration, wow. They think you're amazing, okay? And definitely it came through here, you are my world. You mean everything. You are my world. So you're important to this person is what I'm feeling here. Their thoughts are very strong about you. Something about, again, a completion of some sort of cycle in their life, your life, or as a couple. Because these are general readings and a lot's coming through for you, crystal number three. So they do think you're absolutely beautiful and amazing with this Queen of Inspiration. They're extremely passionate about you as well. They think that you're very passionate. Yeah, there's a lot of desire as well with that card. Let's see. Goddess. You're a goddess, I just heard. You're a goddess. Wow. So this person, So Eight of Emotions. Someone could be walking away from something in their life here, okay? That could be this end of the cycle for some of you, okay? Someone's walking away from a situation from the past, leaving the past behind, clear on something about a new start here with the Ace of Voices, okay? Let's see what the clarifiers. Ace of Voices. Some sort of communication, clearing something up for this person in their thoughts. Maybe their thoughts were a little bit all over the place about something. Ooh, wow. This person's clear they love you, okay, with the Queen of Emotions. They are clear in their mind, in their thoughts, about the love that they feel for you. Queen of Emotions is a deep, powerful, unconditional love, okay? And it's also being open and receptive to love. So they see you as open. They think you're beautiful, very passionate about you as well. So, yeah, I'm feeling like this is something where there's a cycle that's ending either in your relationship that you're walking away from the past, right? So if it's in your relationship, it's leaving adversity behind and moving forward, okay? If it's a new relationship coming in, someone has something going on in their life they had to walk away from in order to bring this connection in, okay? Let's see, what is this World card about? Yeah, planning next steps. So someone's planning next steps toward completing this cycle. Yeah, so there could be action that needs to be taken by this person, and that whatever they're doing, they're thinking about it here. So there's some sort of action to take for them to complete this cycle. It's in their thoughts, and it has to do with you. So I'm assuming if they're ending this cycle here, it's either with you, like I was saying, for some of you, or it's to come toward you. Okay, as I said that, these two popped out. So to come toward you, and Knight of Materials. Ah, yeah, see, ooh. All right, so Knight of Materials, they're wanting to, they feel like you, they think that they've made you feel left out, because they moved forward so slowly is what I'm getting here. Knight of Materials, Five of Materials. Someone feeling left out and very slow moving is what's coming through here. Snail's pace almost. Okay, funny. I think I used that word for YouTube yesterday. The upload was, oh gosh, it was terrible. But anyway, yeah, snail's pace. So someone moved forward really slowly. Maybe this change or completion of a cycle took a while to get to this point. So they felt like they're thinking that you're feeling left out because they've moved slowly. Okay, slow is good, right? In relationships, slow is good. So, but they do feel like you feel left out because of it. Okay, let's see. Eight of Emotions. What is this about? Whoa. Okay, we have Six of Voices and the Six of Inspiration. Two sixes. This is about divine intervention and victory. So the divine could be helping this situation come to an end here, or whatever this cycle is completing. The divine could be helping in order to bring about this victory, okay? So I do feel like this walking away is an integral part of what's in this person's thoughts. This is what they're probably planning here. This walking away is probably what completes that cycle, okay? And brings in this victory. And the Six of Voices is about forward movement. So they're wanting to leave something behind and move forward. Also picking up, like I said, divine intervention there with the Six of Voices as well. Okay, the divine kind of helping this person out. Maybe they're getting communication from their guides. Okay, even that could be it as well. They could be tapping into their inner wisdom and getting some sort of information, communication from our higher beings, right, to kind of help them move forward. Okay, let's see what the oracle cards for crystal number three, please. What is this person's thoughts of crystal number three? We have this card here, and it is resilience. You're very strong. You push through. So you might have been, there might have been some adversity in your life or some things that were a little bit challenging, okay, is what I'm picking up here. And this person thinks that you are very strong. You know, you get through stuff. You handle things well with grace. You handle things well and with grace. Nice. Okay, what else for crystal number three, please? This person's thoughts of crystal number three. This person's thoughts of crystal number three, please. This person's thoughts of crystal number three. Nothing wants to come out. This person's thoughts of crystal number three, please. I always feel it's going to be super specific when it takes a while like that. I've gone through the deck like four times. Oh, there we go. Thank you. Ooh. Balance. So good. So they're thinking about bringing some sort of balance into your life, okay? Love is not always about agreeing just for the sake of it. A great relationship is one that both supports and challenges, okay? So for some of you, this could be what was coming through here with the little bit of adversity or trouble or arguments, things like that in your connection. You've been strong. You get through it with grace, right? And this is the same message, right? You know, it's not about being right or wrong, right? And it's, or agreeing for the sake of it. It's about just dealing with the fact that great relationships are ones that both support and challenge. So it's about getting through that challenge together, okay? So it's, for some of you, I definitely feel like that's the situation, and these cards are connected to that message from earlier, okay? And again, that might not be for everyone, but it definitely is coming through. A few messages here for you. Let's see what else for crystal number three. Very nice message there. So they do think highly of you, and they know that, you know, relationships aren't perfect, and they're willing to work on it. So that is good, right? Walking away. This walking away doesn't necessarily mean physically walking away, right? No, it's about leaving that stuff in the past and moving forward, right? And really settling in to the relationship, even though there's a challenge, right? not giving up so quickly. Not giving up so quickly. So for some of you, maybe you wanted to give up really soon into a relationship or something like that. Push through any insecurity. So they're hoping that they're not making you feel insecure about anything, is what I'm getting here. They're thinking that they might be making you insecure for some reason. Could be this here. The feeling left out and the moving slow. They might be feeling like you're feeling insecure about that, okay? Let's see what else for crystal number three. This person's thoughts of crystal number three. Their person's thoughts of them, please. Openness. Oh, good. So they do feel like you can be expressive, is what I'm getting with this card. They do think that you have a voice. You don't just clam up and shut down and not say anything. You stand up for like what you feel is right. So they feel you're empowered. So that's good. Or they think you're empowered. Feel, same thing. What they're thinking is pretty much what they're probably feeling anyway. So, well, not always, actually, no. Thoughts can really be a disaster sometimes, right? So, yeah, no, they're thinking that, though, so that's good. If their thoughts are that, then their feelings are probably even deeper, okay? Wish upon a star. You've opened my heart. So this person thinks you kind of opened their heart. You kind of cracked them open, okay? With your love, wish upon a star. You're like a dream come true. They don't want to lose you. Ah, see? They don't want to lose you. That person, whoever that is meant for, who is dealing with a little bit of stuff in your relationship, that came through here for you. They don't want to lose you, or it could be for, I mean, you don't have to be in a relationship with someone for someone not to want to lose you either. But I do feel like that definitely is for that person, if that resonates for you. This person, you're very important, okay? I feel, again, you're very important to this person. Nice energy. They think highly of you. They do. They feel you're very nurturing and beautiful, open and receptive, strong, empowered. You know, there's a lot of really nice energy coming through their thoughts here for you. Let's see. And they're clear. They're so clear on how they love you. I am feeling for some of them, it's their guides here with the Six of Voices that really have shined some sort of light on the love within. Okay. Let's see. Crystal number three. Ooh, look at awareness. Yeah, see? They're very aware. They're very self-aware. They think that you are self-aware. Similar. I just heard similar. Similar? Okay. I don't know why that would be coming through with awareness, but similar. So it might mean something to somebody. Similar, they feel you're self-aware, they're self-aware. Maybe you have similar like lifestyles or even levels of awareness, levels of consciousness. That could be it. Okay. All right. A little bit of clarity there. Thank you. Similar levels of consciousness. So you're both kind of on a spiritual path is what I'm feeling there. Okay. Both kind of raising your vibrations. Interesting. So they really do notice. It's on their mind. You're on their mind. Oh, you're on their mind. All the time, apparently. There's a lot in this person's mind for you. Okay, let's see what else. For crystal number three. Co-create. Ooh, yes, man, this is pretty magical. I'm really liking this reading. It's wow, there's something here. There's a lot of like, I felt like I said, they're tapped into their guides. There's a lot of intuitive stuff going on. And now we're talking like, you know, co-creating with the universe. So like law of attraction stuff, right? So there's a lot of awareness between you. This person could be seeing you like manifesting beautiful things into your life, you know, manifesting with ease. I just heard manifesting with ease. So they're wanting like to co-create with you is what I'm getting here. They're wanting to, you know, have a piece of that, so to speak. You know what I mean? Like be involved in that. Or maybe they are involved in that. They could be as well. Maybe they're manifesting great changes into their life as well. Let's see. Okay. I guess that one really wanted to come out. Victory again. Ooh, two messages about victory. This person sees this connection as something, you know, that's going to be victorious, okay? It's going to be a success is what they think here, okay? Very positive thoughts about it. Very nice. Very, very nice energy. Yeah, I mean, you are your thoughts, right? We create with our thoughts, okay? We have to. That's why it's always very important to watch your thoughts and really believe in what you really desire, you know? Believe you can have it and it shall come. A time to rest a while. Ooh. So, yeah, there's a little bit of, they're thinking maybe that you kind of, I feel like you feel, again, left out. Like you're all alone. They might even think that you're sad and like, you know, just kind of hermiting away your solitude or something like that. You're kind of just withdrawn maybe. Maybe you've withdrawn from them, even if you're in a relationship. Maybe you've kind of withdrawn your energy from them or something like that is what I'm getting there. And even if you're not in a relationship with them, maybe you, you know, you stop talking to them or something like that there. Let's see. Let's get some of these for crystal number three. This person's thoughts of them, please. Celebration. Yeah, so they're wanting to celebrate. They're thinking about celebrating your love here somewhere. Okay, maybe a party. Maybe they want to celebrate, plan a party, something like that. They definitely want to kind of what's the word I'm looking for? not show. Ooh, lover's card. I can't think of the word. Sorry. My thinking brain doesn't really work during readings too well. I can't think of the word. They're wanting to like engage with you like in a celebration of some sort. Okay. They could be like thinking like, you know, ooh, going to a party with crystal number three. That would be so much fun, you know, thinking about fun things, wanting to do fun things, stuff like that. Lover's card. So they are feeling and thinking that you are a deep, powerful love in their life. Okay. You mean a lot to this person. Let's see what else for crystal number three. What is this person's thoughts of crystal number three? I was going to get one of these out, and then for crystal number one, I kept going. So, ooh, self-worth. Yeah, they feel you're very self-loving. See, that's what I kind of, with this card here, beautiful, confident, sexy, seductive, or whatever it was that came through. No, it was passionate. Sorry, passionate. This person sees you as very beautiful, taking care of yourself. You know, in your own life, I feel like you are strong, independent, right? But they do feel like you've withdrawn your energy from them. So maybe that's why they're kind of feeling, meditate. Maybe they're kind of feeling, yeah, see, they feel like you've withdrawn. Maybe you are meditating and contemplating something and you're just kind of in solitude. Because it's coming through again. So maybe you have, for some of you, I feel like it's relevant. It came out twice there. For some of you, you might have withdrawn from this person, not necessarily because of anything here. It just might have been for your own reasons, but this person is thinking maybe it's about this, maybe, you know, feeling left out, them moving slowly, so you kind of just gave up on them or something like that, okay? That could be why they're thinking that, but for you, it could be for other reasons altogether, okay, is what I'm getting there. But with self-worth, too, yeah, they see you as very self-loving, you know, like you have a high self-worth. It's very attractive to them. So that came through there, but then I got off track and whatever. Anyway, okay, that is what I have for you for today, crystal number 3. I really hope this reading was helpful. As always, please give it a like and remember to subscribe if you haven't already. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you in the next reading.